Hi, and welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm going to show you how to take the carb from Velo SoleX 3800 apart. We're going to clean it up, check the parts, put it back together again. To take the carb apart, we need two spanner key and a screwdriver, and we're going to use some carb cleaning as well. We're going to start by removing this one here. That's the handle, so when you break down, then it actually closes here, so the gasoline cannot pass, and by default it's on full speed, so that's how the SoleX are. So we're gonna take out this one first. And as you can see, have this one. This is the plastic, this is the arm. And then there's a small spring down here. Can take this one off and can take out this one here. And we can remove this one here. Gonna take out the fuel filter. We can remove this. And can remove the arm here, it'll make it a little bit easier to clean up. And then we're gonna move this one out. Take this one out. So now we have taken the carb apart. We missed to take off this small little plastic one here. Be careful, there's a small washer in here which you need when you put it back together again with the brake cable you're gonna put here. See, wow, that's dirty. So I'm just gonna clean up the different parts, dry them off, then we're gonna clean the carb inside. Basically just gonna run some carb clean through it, and then we're gonna put it all back together again. I've now cleaned the different parts of the carburetor, just dried off the oil and the grease. The next thing is we can clean this one. I'll just blow some carb cleaner through it, then I'll dry it up. Try to get out some of all the dirt. You can probably see down here that there's quite some dirt sitting down here. So we want to get that out. I'm not sure if you can use compressed air to clean it out. I prefer not to. I'll just use this one, spray that in everywhere, and then dry it afterwards. So we're gonna do that. It's gonna create a little mess here on the table, but so then we can dry the carb. And it seems fairly clean now, much better than when we took it apart. Actually, when I bought the SoleX, the carb and the engine and everything was just so dirty from some leaks that there have been. The engine actually ran. I drove it home from the guy where I bought it, but it was really, really dirty. So no surprise that the carb was also very dirty. So now we have cleaned it up pretty much, so we are ready to put it back together again. It's fairly simple to put it back. We have this one that we can put as the first one, put it here, then we can put this one. Gonna tie it. Don't tie it too much. The carb is made of not too hard material, so you might over tie it and actually break it, so be careful with that. I'm gonna put this one, tie that, put the gasoline filter back in. I can put the arm, so that goes. Then we need to put this one in to open and close for the fuel to flow, and it have to be mounted like this. So there is this little pointer here. It have to be in between these two legs, so it can go like that. So here it will be full open. As you can see, there's it's open through, and then here it will be closed, so there'll be very limited full fuel going through. So put that in. I'm not sure if you're supposed to do this, but I just prefer to give it a little drop of oil on each side to put it in, because then it's going to slide more easily. It's probably going to all work out without the oil, especially when the fuel starts to flow, but putting it back together, I prefer to do like this. The next thing we're going to put on is the arm. And on that, we have this little plastic piece. There are two dots here. They need to go in these two holes. And then we can put this one on. This bolt is the one that's gonna hold the cable from the brake when we're gonna put it back on the engine again. Don't have to tie it all in. And then we have this one, which I'll also just give a little drop of oil before we put it back in. And it have to be mounted on this, on this one. And as you can see, there is two holes here, and there's a dot in the hole, so gonna mount it like this. Gonna take this one, put on top. It can be a little bit tricky, and adjust it, and we're gonna tie it in. But we don't want to tie it in all the way, because then the arm will not be able to move freely. So I'm gonna tie it now almost in, and you see it can still move. So before we conclude on this carb, we're just gonna put the spring. We're gonna see if it can move freely. If it can, then it's good. We can try to tie this one a little bit more. See now it starts to not be able to move freely or go all the way back. Just gonna loosen it a little bit, and it's moved freely. So now we have cleaned the carb. All the parts in it look fine. Thank you for watching today's video. Please subscribe to my channel if you want to see more videos where I restore parts or my entire SoleX. Drop a comment under the video. Hope it was useful for you. See you next time.